Good afternoon. Oh, look, it's all working. How is everyone? Yeah, a few nodding heads. I love the bus. How good was the bus? And learning, actually, the fact that education is applicable everywhere, right? I suppose I don't know if I'm in the right place, but I hope I am. Because the section before was sort of more about marketing, and I suppose I live in that world a lot of the time. But I'm going to share a case study today, which is about education again, a project that we did for CBA. But I thought, if I'm standing on stage and I've got I'm from a business called Tricky Jigsaw, I should probably give you a little bit of a scene setter on that. We're part of the M&C Saatchi Group, which you'd probably is traditionally known for advertising. But what we're focused on is products, services, and experiences. And this is a little bit about us, but then I'm going to cut to the chase and take you deep into the world of the case study that we did. So I suppose we're an innovation consultancy. We're a technology company. And we're problem solvers. But we always start with the problem. And what was really interesting about, I suppose, this particular project is, yes, it had a problem. But in fact, the way it started was quite odd. And I'm going to take you through that today. So this is a stat from 2015. This project's actually from 2016-17. And really the fact that actually financial literacy is a real big challenge in this country, and more importantly in rural Australia, when in fact a lot of our kids are leaving school with just the basic knowledge when it comes to sort of dealing with money in the day-to-day. And it's critical, as we all know, as we grow through credit cards and mortgages and suddenly super comes into focus when you hit a certain age, that we do need this literacy. We need to get on top of it. And CBA, who's our client, has really sort of got behind this, and they funded a program called Start Smart. Start Smart is a bit like a role-playing style education experience. They go into schools and they learn about needs and wants, and they really help people understand what's going on. But you can imagine that's not very scalable. Despite the fact that they've achieved great numbers, what it's not doing is the ability for that to kind of spread further. And so we were brought in, and this is where things sort of got interesting, because we don't normally start projects like this. So really it was the fact that we want to do a VR app, Ben. We want to do a game. And you're like, okay, well, let's just see if a game might fit here or not. We don't know yet. Oh, and by the way, we've bought 10,000 Google Cardboards. You're like, oh, right, okay, so we're going down that path, are we? And now that's okay, you might say, because that's all right to start there. But in truth, what it was, well, can we not just explore a little bit more? Anyway, what we tend to do is we build what we call an experience promise, which helps to kind of, I suppose, keep everyone on track through the journey. As you can imagine, we've got multiple stakeholders here. We've got Start Smart, we've got CBA, I've got my creative team, I've got a technology team. And really what we're going to do is just keep everyone in a line going forwards, because you can imagine the suggestions are coming thick and fast, right? We've got budgets to maintain, we've got timelines to hit, all of these things. So this is just a really simple tool that kind of gets everyone into the frame of mind and looks at those possibilities. We knew there was a great opportunity to go down the route of cardboard. If you think about it, it's the easiest way to take someone into this experience. I don't know have people played with cardboard? Simply, you pick up your phone, you put it in this very, very affordable device, and suddenly you're in this world. It's great. It can be posted, it can do all those things. So it wasn't a bad thing to be pushed into. But what we had to do was work out how it all worked. We also had this challenge, which was we were targeting 8 to 9-year-olds. Now, 8 to 9-year-olds is really exciting, but not many have their own device. And also, what we learned quite quickly was they also can get quite nauseous in the experience. We had some teachers come in, we also medical advisors. We had Google Expeditions come in, and really they started to help us see the world that we potentially were going to create. Because what we very quickly learned was the fact that the child can't be in there for any longer than 3 to 4 minutes, or they'll potentially get nauseous. I don't know how long you've spent in a VR experience, but it equally works as well for an adult. Also the fact that they were going to invariably use their parent's device. So what's the parent doing whilst this is all happening? And on top of that, we very quickly realized that Start Smart, which was about going to school, was really the fact that we had to create a lesson that had to go home. So we were making homework here. Now, normally homework doesn't go down too well. Or at least it's a fight. And so all of these insights started to kind of shape the experience for us. And so what we knew was we had to create a story and a narrative to sort of bring the kids into this world. We knew we had to create a shared experience with the parent and the child. And we also knew that the tools that were being actually forced on us, although it turned out to be the right thing in the end, was cardboard. And the fact that we had to be in the app store to get the app in there. So we started developing different stories, and there was lots. Here's just a sample of a few of them. But really this sort of focus of what's the story and then what's the VR opportunity. We knew that it had to be game-like, but also the fact that it had to, more importantly, be about education. And in this instance, the lesson was about needs and wants. We did end up settling on a koala. You saw a sneak peek of it in our hype reel before. And the name changed from Kelly to Sally. But the story stayed the same. We also knew that we had to engage the services of a children's writer to kind of really understand how we could come into the world with the kids. And this gave us a really interesting understanding into how the story could develop. Because what we quickly landed on was the fact that actually we could have physical chapters coupled with virtual chapters. And what it meant was that we created a story time ritual where we had the book and the phone, and the fact of the matter is that parent and child could read through the physical book. The child could then go off into the virtual world. Meanwhile, the parents got cues in the book of what the child is seeing in that experience and can give them pointers as in what they should be looking for or how they should be going. So it became this really lovely ritual. And in fact, with my own children, who were beta testers, it quickly became the go-to bedtime story. And I'm not just saying that, it really did. And you can see here we're sort of working on character development and how we brought that all apart, all to life. So the book was just a simple little book, and as I mentioned, the different chapters and taking people through the experience. It onboarded them into the app, which they had to download onto their Android device or their iPhone, and then basically they got the cardboard in a kit, and then they could basically go into the world. If they didn't get the parcel, they could in fact download a PDF, and they could also use it in a non-virtual world. You could just actually look around and just use it without it close to your eyes, so to speak. This was a sort of point and shoot, for want of a better description, where the user can actually look at what they need to get, and then that basically rushes towards them. So there's no, I suppose, you know, back in 2016 when we were doing this, the chances of pushing it further weren't really there just then. So you can see here, up here, Sammy is looking for stuff to take on her space mission. And then basically there we are blasting off. This is an asteroid game that's built into it. And then ultimately the fact of we're then exploring different planets and then a prompt to return to the book with your parent. We're fortunate to have a lab-type environment, and it was really interesting because the client was quite forthright about how the experience should be. It should just all be in the app. It should only be this experience. But the minute we had parent and child in the lab, everyone quickly realized how the experience had to fit with them. So we were able to iterate on the fly and really get to somewhere very interesting as a shared experience. And I suppose the thing is, you know, in all of these instances, everything from learning about the chemicals to really the bus is the fact of actually understanding how this world sits together and how the different instructors, as well as the users and the roles that live around it. So in this instance, we had a parent, we had a book, we had also the school distributing it and pushing it out. So you ended up with this pack. This is the teleporter or the cardboard. And then Sammy, the book. And I guess we were very happy with where it landed up. And this is the launch video that lived around it.
How can a cardboard box, a smartphone, and a koala change the way kids learn about finance? Introducing the Teleporter Adventures. Join us on a trip through the galaxy to learn financial skills in a fun new way. It's an educational storybook and virtual reality experience for kids and parents to enjoy together. Can your bank take financial education to the next dimension? CommBank can.
So I suppose the big question is, did it work? And ultimately, what we had was really encouraging and incredible stats that lived around this. So 97% of participants completed the full experience, and 76% did it more than once. I think my son did it probably about 15 times because he kept wanting to take a football to space and it wasn't really going to work because he needed a space suit. So he'd get really upset about choosing the wrong thing. So we got there in the end and he started to work out how he could go to the different planets. More importantly, did they understand the difference between needs and wants? And yes, they did. That concept was truly understood. And I suppose what you see here is that Start Smart, which was a role-playing theatrical style thing, could now scale, and this was huge. 98% of participants felt more favorable towards CommBank after completing the experience and would like to participate in future Start Smart initiatives. And more importantly, this became a bit of a foundation for new possibilities. We went on to do some experiments in AR that followed this, and really the fact that everyone saw that this was a great way to bring, I suppose, micro lessons to home and create shared experiences that allowed both the parent and the child to sort of enjoy that together. And this is my favorite one, which is really the fact that in just 10 minutes, they learned more in space than they did on planet Earth. And that's Teleporter Adventures. So thank you so much for your time. My name is Ben, and that was Teleporter. Thank you.